We have with us today Dr. Sudarshan Balal, Chairman Manipal Hospitals and Member Expert Committee, Government of Karnataka. Well, Doctor, social media is filled with autopsy reports suggesting thrombosis as a cause of death. Now, this is as against the classical symptoms of pneumonia, which was spoken of about COVID. Now, should treatment protocols change from ventilators and all that?
Hello, Bansi. Good to be with you. There is a very interesting finding in many of the autopsy reports of COVID patients, and many of them have had thrombosis or clotting of the blood vessels. This is related to what they call as a cytokine storm, or the body's extreme immune response to this virus. Treatment protocols have been modified, now being based more on anti-inflammatory and sometimes anticoagulant protocols rather than just the use of ventilators. It's still a little too early in the course of the disease for us to be sure as to what the best protocol would be.
Most hospitals are functioning at 10 to 20% capacity with just peripheral staff. What is happening to the really sick patients requiring intensive management, like myocardial infarction, cardiac surgeries, dialysis, cancer patients, transplants, and so on?
Another very interesting part is that this must be the only pandemic in recent times, at least in our country, where the hospital facilities are being underutilized. The reason for this is, one, we have fortunately not seen too many sick COVID patients, and there is a huge decrease in other sick patients getting to the hospital because of less road traffic accidents and even less respiratory illnesses, maybe because of the betterment of general hygiene, hand washing, physical distancing, so on and so forth.
A very interesting paradox in this pandemic is that the hospital occupancies and outpatient visits have dramatically come down. This raises the question of what happens to the regular patients and the emergency patients who used to come to the hospital. Obviously, our own figures are that dialysis and chemotherapy continues as before. Emergency surgeries also continue as before. However, there is a significant drop in the elective cases and also drop in the ICU admissions and the seriously ill patients on ventilators. This may be as a result of less number of serious infections because of the hygienic measures and probably difficulty in traveling because of the lockdown. But we do believe that seriously ill patients can still make it to the hospital and be taken care of.
Now, the task force consisting of yourself, Dr. Devi Shetty, Dr. Manjunath, suggested easing lockdown with extension of 2 weeks. What are you suggesting?
Though lockdown was and is necessary to slow down the progression of COVID, there are many other measures which need to be continued, including cough etiquette, physical and social distancing, hand hygiene, keeping your surroundings clean, avoiding overcrowding, and certainly being aware of this disease and taking necessary precautions to prevent this. Even after the lockdown has been removed, many of these measures need to continue to prevent not only COVID but similar respiratory illnesses. We also should continue to live with working from home whenever possible, which is another very good measure, not only for the disease but for the planet in general.
Now, if we look at the zoning, the color zoning puts Bengaluru under red altogether. Now, there are about 1 crore people here. Do we need micro zoning for a massive city like this?
The government has rightly divided the country into various zones, green, orange, and red, based on the number of cases of COVID that is seen. This certainly is a good step because you'll take the maximum precautions in the red zone and lesser precautions in the orange and green zones. It will also be very useful to make sure that people in the red zone can be converted into an orange or green zone by these extraordinary measures. Technically, it may be more difficult to further zone the country other than the district-wise zoning that's been done. However, there are hotspots identified across the country where there are extreme lockdowns, which certainly is the need of the hour to contain the disease. So I do believe the zoning of the country is an appropriate measure and hope sooner or later we'll see only green zones and none of the other zones.
If you look at the testing kits from China, there have been a lot of murmurs. What are your views on it? Also, is testing a primary requirement for the unlocking process? Also, what is the status of testing, that is testing kits available in our country?
As far as the testing of the various citizens for COVID is concerned, it is generally believed more testing is needed. And as of now, most of the testing is still with the government sector, though they have opened up the private sector. For various reasons, we have not ramped up the testing to a great extent, but work is in progress. And I think today we are doing a lot more testing than what we were doing about a month ago. However, the interesting thing is that we might have missed some cases of COVID because of the lack of testing, but we do believe that the number of seriously ill patients or deaths due to COVID is very, very few in this country. With or without testing, the number of admissions to the ICU for COVID, or for that matter, any other respiratory illness, is far below than what was expected. And this is indeed a very, very good sign for the country because we haven't had the misfortune of dealing with very seriously ill patients like what has happened in the US and Europe. Chinese test kits have been suspect, and even ICMR has requested the organizations not to go through the Chinese kits, and hopefully better quality kits will be available in the future. The government has gone to extreme levels in ordering more kits and making more kits available, and I'm sure the testing facilities will be far better in the near future.
Is it just enough to continue the lockdown indefinitely?
There have obviously been many debates on the way out of the lockdown. The government is the best body to determine the duration and the kind of the lockdown. And obviously, medical advice will be given by the experts in the field. Certainly, the lockdown has helped our country in slowing down the progression of COVID among our citizens. And it's a very thin line to walk between extension of the lockdown and its effect on the economy versus saving lives. Even though the lockdown has been continued, there have been some relaxation, and we are hoping that over a period of time, the government will come out of the lockdown in a very phased manner.
Some suggest that those over 55 years or those with comorbidities need to be compulsorily locked down. The others can be free to be normal with their daily lives. Is that a sensible suggestion?
There are some people who are at higher risk of not only getting the infection, but also getting seriously ill. This includes the elderly population, people with other comorbid conditions like cardiac disease, diabetes, immunocompromised state, so on and so forth. These individuals need extraordinary care to prevent the disease, and hence they need to stay indoors, avoid contact, social distancing, and all the other measures that are needed to prevent the disease from spreading to them. So I would urge, even after the lockdown is over, that this specific population be more careful and protect themselves from the coronavirus.
What is your take-home message about the way forward?
Coronavirus is here to stay for some time. We have had similar viral illnesses like SARS, H1, N1, etc. And we have gotten over those viruses and the fear of those viruses. And so will we of the corona. Do not fear the coronavirus. Be prepared and let life go on.